Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum. How are you, my sweet little gents? Are you okay? I hope so that you are enjoying your vacations and you are very nice. So today we are again going to study Rockmark English students book 2. Yes, bring your book today. And on the book we are going to do a very interesting topic related to the verbs. On page number 40, today it's turn to do some grammar. It's a grammar time. And in a grammar time today we are going to discuss two forms of verbs. There are some regular verbs and some irregular verbs. These are the two different kinds of verbs. The regular verbs are those simple verbs that when we have to convert those words into the past tense or the past participles, when we have to convert into their second or the third form, we simply add -de or -de at the end of that root word, okay? As a suffix of that root word, we add -de or -de, and easily we convert those words, those verbs into the past and past participle forms in the second and third form of verb. Those all verbs are called the regular verbs. What are the regular verbs? Regular verbs are those verbs whose past tense and past participles are formed by adding a -de or -de to the end of the verb. Verb ke end par simply D or ED dalne se uski second or third form ban jati hai. And on your book, page number 40, they have given us a list of some regular verbs. For example, help, helped, helped, live, lived, lived, call, called, called, play, played, played. There is one more list of all these simple examples. So regular verbs are completely clear to you, okay? Today I would like to explain you some irregular verbs. You know what are the irregular verbs? Irregular verbs are those verbs that when we have to convert these verbs into the past or past participle forms, they don't end on -de or just -de. Rather, they change their spellings, they change their forms, okay? So, we can say like this, that a verb in which the past tense is not formed by adding the usual -de or -de in the ending is called an irregular verb. Yes, ek aisa verb jiske end par ed or d lagane se uski second or third form nahi banti, usko hum regular verb nahi bolte. Usko hum kya bolte hain? Irregular verb. Okay, regular verbs are those verbs which ends with -de or -de, and irregular verbs are those verbs which will not end with -de or -de to make their second and third form, to make their past participle and past tense. Got it? Understand? Now, in your book, they have given us some examples of irregular verbs also. For example, go, went, gone. Go is the present form, went is the past form, and gone is the past participle, the third form of verb. So, over here, can you see that go is not using -de or -de to make the forms? Rather, complete spellings are changed. Same is the case with come. Come, came, come. Come is the first form, past form is came, and past participle form is again come. It is not comed and comed. Got it? We have not added -de. Understand? Yes. The difference between regular and irregular verb is clear to you? Good. Very good. They have given you some examples of irregular verbs also. There are two verbs. I would like to read some for you. Run, ran, run. Do, did, done. Bring, bought, bought. Cut, cut, cut. Cut ki to second form bhi cut hai aur third form bhi cut hai. Interesting. You have to learn all these regular and irregular form of verbs in the proper way. Understand? Now it's your turn to do an activity. What you have to do? You have to write down 6 regular verbs and 6 irregular verbs. It is an easy task, okay? You can pick up any 6 words from the list of the regular verbs and you can pick up any 6 words from the list of the irregular verbs, okay? After doing the concept of regular and irregular verb, it's a turn to know something about very interesting. Yes, an interesting fact. Can you see in the bottom of page number 40? We can see a lot of cycles over there. A lot of boys are doing cycling. So, what is the fact written over here? The fact is it that there are over 500 million bicycles in China. Wow, very interesting information it is. What they are telling us in the interesting fact, they are telling us that in China a lot of people use bicycle, and they used to do the cycling for their regular pursuits. Over here in our country, we people are not using a lot of cycles, and that's really not good. Okay, all of you will try your best to use the cycles and to do cycling. You know what, to do cycling is very good for our health also. It increases the height of the students. Yes, if you want to be very heighty, you should do the cyclings in this age, okay? And in China, it is a very traditional thing. In China, people used to go out on cycling. People used to go out on cycle. That's really very comfortable for all of them. So, all of you are also supposed to do the cycling. Interesting fact is it that in China, over 500 million bicycles are over there, okay? In this way, we have completed our page number 40. Next page, we will do in the next video. Till that, you will learn your all form of verbs in the proper way and prepare it for your assessment. Till that, keep in touch. Stay watching. Allah Hafiz.